Johnny. 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 You were yelling in your sleep again. The same dream?
Teach me to fly, to never die. We'll go away from the shadow. We'll fly into the light. Sweet light. Take me away from the darkness and teach me to see. Angel of joy, catching the light. Angel take me to some place I dream of, where nothing is wrong, where I belong. You see, I have to, I want to go home. Go.
Johnny, look at this.
What do you got?
I don't know.
It's a cactus cord.
Oh! Huh. What is it?
Don't you hear that?
What? Johnny? Well, what is it?
I don't know. I hear something, but it's strange.
Johnny! Horrible. Johnny, come on, let's get out of here. Johnny? Johnny?
I'm sorry, Kat. I keep forgetting they turn everybody else off.
God, it's ugly.
I'll get rid of it. We can get going.
Johnny, can't we skip the caves for today and go right onto the slopes?
Oh, I'd kind of like to make the last tour, Kat, if we can.
Is it so important?
Well, of course not. It's just my work. That's what the weekend's all about, remember?
I remember something else. This weekend is also supposed to be an overdue honeymoon.
You're right. I can do it later. Come on.
Oh, Johnny, you're right. Your work is important. We'll catch the last tour.
You sure now?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Something down here makes me feel primitive.
You haven't got the nerve.
Try me.
You're on, lady.
Kathy! Kathy!
Johnny, please, hurry!
Kathy! Are you all right?
Yes, they're crawling all over me.
They're mites, honey. Just keep on the skin.
Oh! How do we get out of here?
Kathy, I don't know. The best thing we can do is wait. Now, sooner or later, they'll figure we're missing. They'll send somebody for us.
Johnny, please, let's get out of here.
Kathy,
let's try that.
Kathy!
No! The best thing we can do is stay put.
I'm sorry.
Don't be silly. Our honeymoon was getting a little dull anyway.
Same thing I heard before.
The bats.
I don't hear anything.
Quiet. One of them is getting closer.
Tell me.
You wanted to examine it for rabies. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh. Don't worry about it.
Stupid. Why did I kick it away?
Yep, we could have had some good stew, you know.
Yuck.
It tastes just like white meat of tuna. That's what they tell me.
You're disgusting.
Have you ever thought about what we look like to a bat?
I don't care about bats. I care about you.
And I care about you. And bats.
Look at that. Isn't it beautiful?
Yes. Oh, what a run that's going to be. Magnificent. I'm so glad. I'm really happy.
I love you.
to us, Johnny. Johnny!
Leave me alone!
Your hand! Johnny! Johnny, what's the matter with you? You gotta see a doctor.
Oh,
your hand!
It was an accident.
I don't care what it was. Please, come on. Please.
No, it's not serious.
Not serious.
All right. I'll stop in the first aid station first thing in the morning.
Yeah, that looks pretty good.
That's not bad.
What are we going to do about that?
That can wait.
You're the doctor. But promise me something. You start treatment just as soon as you get back, huh?
You mean the Pasteur treatment?
Mm-hmm. Look, you two, there's a minimum 30-day incubation period, so there's no reason to spoil the weekend.
Is it true that the cure is sometimes worse than the disease?
Nothing is worse than rabies.
Thanks a lot, Doctor.
Johnny, I think...
Jeff, honey, it's not that big a deal. We can wait till next week.
I don't think a week will make any difference. I am going skiing.
Oh, don't let anything stop you, Doctor. He's only a patient.
Take it easy, Kath.
And you're being as irresponsible as he is. You're working on a grant in preventive medicine, and you won't take it yourself. You're not doctors, you're children.
You ready to go, Doctor?
I'm ready, Doc. Where are we going?
Hospital. About 5 miles down the hill in town. Come on.
You happy, Doc?
Yes.
You prefer this to another day in the slums, do you? Mm-hmm. Don't worry about it. It's strictly routine procedure.
Maybe. You're strictly special, and I don't want anything to happen to you.
Kath, nothing's happening.
Oh.
Mrs. Beck, I can only handle one emergency a day. Would you mind waiting in the solarium?
Go ahead, Kath. It'll only take a minute. Numero uno. 19 to go.
What is it? What's happening?
I'm burning up.
Oxygen.
Burning.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? You're having an allergic reaction. Try to breathe slowly.
Can't breathe at all.
Sodium phenobarb. I think it's all right. Prepare a room for Dr. Beck. He'll be staying here, nurse.
Yes, Doctor.
It's a hell of a ride.
What a reaction. Never seen anything like that before.
It's like rabies itself.
Well, from what I understand, allergic reaction can produce identical symptoms.
isn't it? The answer probably 1 in 1,000,000. And where is it hit? I research him, you know, I just terrific.
I guess the bats are getting even.
Yeah. What's your opinion about the rest of the shots?
You mean, do I think you're going to have another reaction like this? I doubt it. I think that was just the initial jolt. The rest of the shot should have minimal effect.
Good.
Dr. Kipling? Dr. Kipling? Dr. Kipling, I'm sorry to bother you.
You promise not to bawl me out anymore?
Okay.
You know, you were right. I am kind of a ski bum.
Doctor, one of the nurses told me what happened.
You shouldn't have done that.
How serious is it?
You mean his reaction to the serum?
Yes.
I wouldn't call it serious at all.
But is that it?
Huh?
Is it possible there may be other side effects?
Yes. There is a possibility of side effects, but I wouldn't worry about it.
But it was a violent reaction, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. Obviously, he is allergic to the serum, but that's not unusual in itself. The Pasteur treatment can produce reactions very, very similar to rabies. Like sudden shifts in mood, manic depression, paranoia, inability to swallow.
But that's what I don't understand, Doctor. He had those reactions. Everything you're describing, before he took the serum.
I don't know what you mean.
It was really strange. On the gondola and in the jacuzzi, he had these sudden fits of anger. He was completely without any problems 1 minute, and then in the next he was like a madman, completely out of control. And he wasn't even aware of it.
Mrs. Beck, I want to assure you of one thing. Now, whatever you saw in him, believe me, it wasn't rabies. The incubation period is 1 to 5 months.
Doctor, what if he does have rabies?
I wouldn't worry about it. We got an early start on the treatment.
Even if it's not fatal, there's a good chance of brain damage, isn't there?
Come on, let's go.
Medical sample. What is that?
A lot of excitement this morning. What happened?
There's nothing for you to be concerned about.
Nurse, I'm a doctor. I am concerned.
Right now, you are a patient, doctor.
Something happened. What was it?
It was an accident.
Kind of accident.
Final call. All student nurses come to the
night nurse. She fell.
How bad?
She's good morning, darling. How did you ever get that off? It took two strong men and a boy to get it on.
Kathy, I want you to find a psychiatrist.
What?
Well, once in your life, just do the hell I ask. Can't you see I'm in trouble?
Well, the doctor says you're doing fine.
Find somebody, Kathy, now.
Well, of course, darling, I will. Just as soon as I get you settled.
What are you talking about?
In the motel.
They won't let me leave, Kathy.
Didn't you talk to the doctor? He says you don't have to stay here. I've already signed you out.
I think I should stay close to the hospital for a while anyway.
But there's no reason.
I want to. Isn't that reason enough?
Okay.
Dr. Clark, report to surgery. Dr. Clark, to surgery. Okay.
No. It's not okay. I'm coming home with you.
You don't have to.
Yes, I do. Why don't you go on ahead and find us something for a nice quiet dinner?
You do feel well enough.
Yeah. And forget the psychiatrist. That's fine. How much is that?
$20.
Thank you. Gift wrap that, please.
Doctor? Sergeant Ward, Sheriff's Department. How you feeling, Dr. Beck?
I'm fine. How did you know my name?
I've been following you, Doc. Just missed you at the hospital. You sure you're all right now?
Look, Sergeant, I'm taking a series of preventive shots. I don't need to stay at the hospital, and you are not a doctor. So just what can I do for you?
Take it easy, Doc. All I want to do is talk a little. Now, if I had a pretty young wife like yours, and I brought something home like this, there's no telling what you might think. You know what I mean?
Well, when I guess you get around to it, Sergeant, you'll know where to find me.
Oh, Doc. What I wanted to mention is I'm checking out the accident at the hospital. Last night?
I don't know how I can help you.
Well, you see, your room's pretty close to where it happened. Thought you might have heard something. You know what I mean?
Not a thing. I was asleep.
Yeah, I figures what with all you've been through. Reason I ask you is, I found this near the body. It's yours.
I don't understand how it got there.
Yeah, that's what I keep wondering, too. Same way I keep wondering how it got off, you know what I mean?
I don't know.
Try it. Real puzzler, ain't it?
Hi.
Guess so.
I think I got slipped oregano again.
Attention. All cars in the vicinity of Blair High School. Janitor reports group of vandals rampaging through school. Relay 604-911-716.
My old lady will have my head for this. Listen, I had a great time.
Whoopee.
Meow!
It's like the others. Just a dream. That's all. A dream. Who is it?
Sergeant Ward.
What do you want, Sergeant?
I'd like to talk to your husband.
Can it wait till morning, Sergeant? It's 3 a.m.
No.
Get back to bed, Kathy.
Sergeant, it was so important in the middle of the night.
Kind of an inconvenient hour, I guess, but there's been one or two things that have been bothering me, and I thought I'd better talk to you.
About what?
Murder.
Murder?
This little girl had her throat ripped out a couple hours ago.
What does that have to do with me?
Well, nothing, Doc. I'm just talking to a lot of folks. Been in all night, have you?
Yes, of course. My wife will verify that.
She don't have to do that, Doc. You're not on the stand, you know what I mean?
You haven't told me what you wanted, Sergeant.
Oh, yeah. Well, you ever seen this before? The girl ripped it off whoever attacked her.
Are you implying that's why?
I guess if you've seen one bag, you've seen them all, huh? Right, Doc? Night.
Take these. They'd knock out an elephant. They'll help you with the nightmares.
I'm not sure there were nightmares.
Look, I'm not a psychiatrist, far from it. But I think what happened is pretty obvious. You were running a very high fever, and you wandered out of your room, and you spotted the nurse lying on the floor, dead. You panicked. You rushed back to your room. Now, you're in a state of near coma. Then you distorted the sequence of events. In your mind, you killed the nurse.
Why?
You're a doctor. You didn't help her. Guilt. Same reason I'm here instead of up on the hill.
What about the man I killed? I smashed his brains out.
Let's look at that, huh? In your condition, you picked up a fully grown man. You flung him around your head like he was some kind of rag doll. You had a high fever. That's what produced the nightmares. Very real to you, but images.
They were incredibly real.
That's not unusual, is it? You know as well as I do, high fever can produce hallucination.
What about that? There was no flesh left on my fingers. I can't get it back on now.
Fever, man. You were perspiring heavily. It slipped off.
That's what you think all that means?
I don't know. It's your dream.
wants to stay in the hospital until the treatments are over. Alone.
I'd go along with him if I were you, Mrs. Beck. He's had a severe trauma. It was pretty rough.
What can I do to help?
Give him all the support he needs. No pressure. I think his mind will ease up just as soon as these treatments are over.
Good morning. For you.
Thank you, sir.
You want one?
No, not now.
Oh, I talked to your mother.
You didn't.
Oh, you promised to call her, remember?
What did you tell her?
I told her you were fabulous.
Uh-huh. And she didn't insist on talking to me?
Oh, she did. But I said you were asleep. Said the honeymoon was too much for you.
Now we're going to keep on hearing about grandchildren, you know that.
Well?
Well?
Johnny, what's wrong?
I'm tired. I better get a little rest.
I'll get the doctor.
No, I want a little rest, that's all.
Johnny, you...
Just get the hell out of here and leave me alone!
Johnny!
This isn't happening. It's in my mind. It's in my mind. Please, no. I must stay. I need help.
Sergeant Ward, who is the patient who stole that ambulance?
Male Caucasian.
What's his name?
Beck. Dr. John Beck.
This is Unit 1 in pursuit of stolen ambulance. Now headed south on 14th Street. All units converge.
cars converge at Mill Road. Stolen ambulance westbound. Suspect homicidal.
Of course he was with me all night.
Every minute together, I never apart.
What's the point of this, Sergeant?
We had a young girl killed the other night over at King's Trailer Park. She died pretty much the same way as the nurse the other night.
But that was an accident.
I don't think so anymore, Mrs. Beck. You recognize this?
No. Should I?
Found in the trash barrel at your motel.
So?
Well, the man who killed that girl was wearing it.
I told you, Johnny never left my side.
Well, tell me this. When Dr. Beck ran off...
He didn't run off. He was hallucinating, and that was from the medication.
Well, do you believe this medication could have made him violent?
Oh, Johnny's never done a violent act in his life.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably never stole an ambulance and smashed it to bits in his life either. You know what I mean?
I'm sorry, sir. I thought you were somebody else, but I knew.
Beginning to know the real me.
Yes, sir.
You're one of the few people who's fortunate enough to know the real me.
Because I'm free, man. Free. Free as a... Shit.
You know that whiskey and alcohol and all that stuff is depressing? Who do you suppose to want? Take this stuff if they didn't want to be depressed. If you're so free and happy, you don't want to be depressed. You want to stay free and happy, right? So if I'm so freaking free and happy, I would never even take a swig from this bottle, right? All right. I'd only take swigs, man. I drink it from the bottom of the bottle. And I get more and more depressed. I get so depressed I don't remember. And I goodbye another night or day. Or maybe a couple of nights if I'm lucky. That's what I call real freedom, man.
Something wrong with you, Ron?
I slipped and fell, I think, a couple nights ago. I don't remember.
Let me see that.
Bingo! You found it. Let go, for Christ's sake.
Your hand is broken.
You, doctor?
So
you're a doctor and you dropped right on out. I understand that. I sure do. You know too much. Anybody who knows too much has got to drop out.
You're quite a philosopher.
That's me. Jack of all thoughts, master of none. You know, when you walk along the railroad tracks, you got lots of time to think. Just thinking, no doing. If it's the slightest chance I might start doing, I just naturally reach for a bottle. I can say for sure there's only one thing I can do better than anybody else in the world. Stink. Right? Hey, Doc, have yourself a swig. You're looking awful. Go on. I know this stuff's bad, but not that bad.
Attention, APB. Dr. John Beck. Roll all units. Every man.
Yes, sir, every man. But Harmon, he's at the hospital with his wife. She just had a baby.
I don't give a damn if she had quintuplets. Everybody.
Doc, you're giving the case. Where are you, sir? What's going on?
Jeff?
My brother.
Professional job.
Yeah, a humane act if I ever saw one.
Thank you.
Come on, you can't walk the streets all night.
Where could he be, Sergeant?
You let me worry about that, Mrs. Beck. We'll find him. Come on.
Okay. Thank you, Sergeant.
You're welcome. Here, let me do that. I know how rough it must be, Mrs. Beck. It's a bad time to be alone.
Thank you.
Ah, forget it. Everybody needs a friend once in a while. Anything I can do. Sensitive young girl like yourself needs all the protection she can get.
I'm all right. Johnny.
Oh, yeah. Him, too. Tell me something, Miss Beck. How long have you been married?
Almost a year. No, thank you.
Things have been going pretty good, have they?
It's been very good, Johnny, and I'm very happy.
Sure you are. I gotta ask those kind of questions in my business. He a physical type person, would you say?
I don't know what you mean.
Like sports, does he? That sort of thing.
Well, yes. He's pretty athletic.
He ever hit you?
Hit me?
Yeah, you know, folks with a temper sometimes do things like that. You know what I mean?
No, Sergeant. Johnny has never hit me. And I don't like what you're getting at.
Well, what am I getting at, Mrs. Beck?
We've been through that. Johnny's not capable of hurting or killing anyone. Not Johnny. Not Johnny. To help him.
I'll do the very best I can, Kathy.
No!
Well, don't you worry about a thing, Mrs. Beck. I'll find him.
The dark area that we see on the left, where early explorers came into the cave. The rocks over which those people climbed give us an idea of just how rough cave exploring may be. The rocks fell from the ceiling just a few years ago. By a few years, we mean somewhere in the neighborhood of 8,000 to 10,000 years, which is just a small period of time in the total period that the cave has been here. But it's far enough back so that we can say that everything that was loose or likely to fall fell thousands upon thousands of years ago. We are safer here from falling objects than we would be on the surface outside this mountain. We don't actually make comment on the rocks, to make people feel more safe, but really to allow people's eyes to adjust to the light conditions within the cavern.
Fourth water drips in the streamline, and therefore a stalagmite develops directly below a dripping stalactite. So if the stalactite goes down a little deep droplet of water, the stalagmite goes up a little. I think that everybody has a pretty good idea how stalactites develop. Water drips from the ceiling for a long period of time. Each droplet of water that falls from the ceiling, a little tiny bit of mineral is left behind on its surface. Something that people aren't usually familiar with, though, is that the little tiny bit of mineral.
Tell me where the anti-rabies vaccine is stored.
In the cabinet.
Thank you.
You knew around here, too? Dr. Winston? Can I help you, please? What's the matter, Dr. Winston? Dr. Winston, please, can I go? Doctor, I'm going to get some help.
Where is he?
He's in the pharmacy.
might have found him.
My name is John Beck. This is my last will and testimony. My final communication with the outside world. Many will deny as possible the phenomenon, the miracle, which has forever altered my being, emotionally, mentally, physically. A few, perhaps, will understand. I hope that you, Kathy, will be one of them. You are my one sorrow. The only regret that I take with me. Always remember, I loved you. The first symptoms of my metamorphosis were strange and horrible, medically indescribable. But now the metamorphosis is swift, quite smooth, painless, natural. I welcome it. It is only then that I am fully the other being, the self that dominates my personality. Human form and human emotion.
No, I won't listen. Don't you see? He's taking on the guilt for something he doesn't even understand. How can you believe something so irrational?
You heard the same thing we heard, Mrs. Beck. That was a confession.
A confession? From someone pumped full of medicine? He doesn't know what he's saying.
I think it's more complex than that, Mrs. Beck.
How he got there, that's out of my bailiwick. All I know is that you're listening to a voice of a killer.
Something within my psyche has emerged, has helped me reach a new consciousness, a sharp awareness of truth, untouched by human greed or ambition, free from the negative, the hypocrite. Can you understand? I'm part of everything now. I've journeyed to a belonging.
Oh, God, turn it off. Please, turn it off.
Do you think he really believes he's changed, Doc?
Yes. You say that kind of funny, Doc. Like maybe you believe it yourself.
I don't think you quite understand. He believes it. Therefore, it is true.
Oh, God. You did come back.
Keep your hand off the light, Kathy.
It's all right. No one can see us.
I don't want you to see me.
Johnny. Johnny, I love you.
Stay back.
That's all finished, Kathy.
What are you talking about?
Something you could never understand.
Oh, Johnny, please. Let me try.
Nothing can be the same, Kathy. Can't you understand that? Nothing.
Let me help you.
Go home.
Alone? I couldn't go without you, Johnny.
Go home, Kathy.
But it's your home, too.
No.
What do you say?
The caves are my home.
Who is it?
You haven't seen your husband, have you?
No, of course not.
You mind if I come in?
Yes, I do, Sergeant. I'm in bed. It's very late.
I had a report he was seen in the area. Good night, Mrs. Beck.
Good night. It's all right. You're all right. You look fine, Johnny.
I can't control it, Kathy. I do change.
No, you don't change, Johnny. You think there's a change of some kind, but that's because of the drugs. It's in your mind. Don't you see? It's nothing more than an allergic reaction.
I'm leaving, Kathy.
No. The police may be watching. Johnny, I love you.
No, no.
I do. And you love me too.
Mrs. Beck, are you all right? Mrs. Beck, you must have been having a nightmare. Are you okay now?
Oh, yes, of course, I'm sorry.
Boy, it must have really been a bad one. Well, listen, I'm heading back to the office now, but if you need me, or if you have another one of those nightmares, you just give me a yell, okay? And I'll be over there. All night. Don't you worry. You take it easy. I got no other place to go, believe me. Okay? Good night, Mrs. Beck.
Sergeant Ward, headquarters. Do you read me? Sergeant Ward, headquarters.
Yeah, I read you.
Mrs. Beck was here looking for you. She was hysterical. She kept babbling you killed her husband. She got a ranger to drive her to the cave.
When?
A few minutes ago.
And I'll take care of it. 10-4.
You're gonna come along with me peacefully. You know what I mean?
Come on.
Sergeant, is my husband all right?
I don't know what he is.
Well, what happened?
I don't know what happened. All right, that's enough. Let's go.
No. Listen.
I don't hear anything.
Strange. I hear something, but I don't know.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing you would understand. You ready, Sergeant?
God. They're attacking us. What the hell's wrong with you? Can't you see what's happening?
Yes, I see.
Emergency! Emergency! This is Ward. Emergency! Emergency! Hey, what are you doing?
Goodbye, Sergeant.
Come on.
Take me to...